Hey guys, welcome back to the Citystead. Today I am going to show you how I made my urban hugelkultur bed. As you can see, we got a lot of strawberries in here. I got some volunteer tomatoes that came back. When we first did this last year, it wasn't really used for anything. I wanted to put strawberries over here, and because they were so small, I decided I would interplant a bunch of other stuff. So we ended up having a few different herbs and tomatoes and stuff, and the tomatoes have come back for us, which is pretty awesome because they were the sun golds and they were really good. So I'm hoping we got the same variety that came back here. It's not some kind of transplant from the other side of the yard. But these strawberries are incredible. This is the largest I've ever had a strawberry plant get on my property. And I've been trying to grow these suckers for a while. And the hugelkultur bed seems to really work, at least for them. And it worked pretty good on the tomatoes that grew in here last year also. So the hugelkultur bed, the ideal is to fill in a bunch of natural organic matter in here to work as like a sponge to help water retention and release it as it breaks down. Kind of like replicating a forest, like if a tree falls and things blow over it and it decomposes and the dirt goes over top of it. So I guess that's ideally what it's supposed to replicate in a smaller scale possibly. Like we're doing these raised beds, we actually have a frame for them. I've seen a lot of people just hill this up. You know, hugelkultur is a German word for, I can't remember exactly what it's for, but it was invented, you know, in Germany by the hill culture people. So this is how they garden a little bit, and they use them for windbreaks and swells, different things like that, and they're planting on. Well, putting all that wood in there takes up a lot of space, because if you're filling up a raised bed with dirt, you know that it costs you a lot of money. Whereas if you're putting debris from your yard in there and then putting just a little dirt on top of it, within a couple of years you're going to have a really rich soil bed and at a much cheaper cost than buying a whole bunch of dirt. So that's kind of what I wanted to show you guys. What we're going to be doing today is doing another one of these, but a little bit smaller over in the garden area. And I'm going to take you over there and we'll show you what we're doing. All right, so when I built the other one on the other side of the yard, I did a similar thing. I built the little frame. I put it where I wanted it to be, and you can see here I've dug out a little bit. The dirt's all the way down a little bit below where the bottom of my bed is, and it's actually sitting down in the ground a little bit. It's kind of hard to see, but it's down in the ground just a little bit. It's just 1x8s that I used, nothing too fancy, just screwed them together. And like I said, I dug the grass out. Now I'm keeping that grass. I got it over here, and I'm going to use that as a green matter for when I'm filling this back in. So we're gonna put some branches, twigs, and some, you know, dead grass that I got from different times of the year that we've collected. We'll put that at the bottom for our bottom layer, and that's gonna be where we get all the breakdown, the moisture retention. We're gonna put this back on top of it, and then I have a little bit of dirt in the wheelbarrow. We'll put that on there, and possibly we might need one bag of dirt to fill it out. So I gotta go get some branches. We're gonna fill some branches up in here and get working on this. Okay, so we filled it up with some big old logs and stuff. We got a lot of small branches. I joke around about this being the urban hugelkultur bed because normally what you would do is have large trees that fall. You would cut up those logs and you'd use them or lay a whole tree trunk. Now, I don't really have a lot of land, you know, because I don't have anything to chop down to use like this. I don't have deadfall. But what I do have is small branches that are constantly breaking off of big trees and just yard debris. So this is why I did this as an experiment last year, just to see if I could reuse some of this material, because I only have so much room in my compost bin. So I'm trying to find constantly ways to reuse my materials that I have naturally on my yard, as opposed to purchasing new materials or anything like that. With the compost being nearly full, trying to get that to break down, I looked into this and I thought, hey, that's a good way to use a lot of that debris that falls in my yard and grass and leaves and whatnot that we get. So we're gonna do that. Try this out again, see if this bed's as successful as the first one. So I put all these logs down here. I got a lot of branches. I filled it up maybe halfway to the wood frame here. And now I'm gonna go get some dead grass that we pulled, some weeds. I'm gonna pile a little bit of layer of that in here. Some of the stuff is relatively fresh, still pretty green, but it'll break down and die still. Now the next step would be to take this sod that I pulled off the top with the grass on it still and put it in here kind of upside down to give me more of a base of dirt. So we put all that sod back on there. We're pretty full on this thing. I'm gonna pour that dirt I put over in the wheelbarrow over top of it, and we'll see how far that gets us. But we might have to add any more to this. All right, we filled it up. That was pretty good. I mean, the dirt's all the way to the top. I'm gonna wait a couple days before I plant anything, see if it settles down any. I'm sure a little bit of rain, a little bit of time, it'll start settling down a little bit more. Some of that dirt will fall through the cracks and we'll see how full it looks then. But it's hilled up a little bit, so I'm thinking we're gonna be all right. So this is my urban Hugelkultur bed. Cost me a total of about $6. I bought that board. Made, what, 4 cuts on it and screwed it together with some screws that I already had. So I don't know what the total cost would be, maybe $8. But if you're looking to make raised beds in your yard and you're not sure of a good way to do it, this Hugelkultur method is really good. And you could also just dig a hole, fill it with those branches and pile the dirt back on top of it and have mounds as opposed to the raised bed like I have. You would just have no sides and it would be more of an arch with your dirt. That's a pretty good way to make a cheap raised bed, and so far it's doing really good on the other side of my yard for my strawberries. We'll see what this does this year for whatever we plant in it, and hopefully next year will be even better. So that's the urban Hugelkultur bed, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Citystead out.